on the top.
Det er godt noget
ud. Det er
godt.
Jeg kan godt se, at det er lidt mørkere, end jeg bruger
det. Ja, det er lidt spørgsmål, jeg brænder igennem, hvis det er.
Yeah, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft, and Martin from Northern Woodsmen. We are out here in Hammer Hills today, making a Viking trip, as you can see, together for the first time. And it's very excited to come out here and show Martin this area I've been in before. And to mark that, I actually bought some mead. I bought it last time, but I said to Martin, bring a drinking horn and I'll share some mead with you. And I think you have, yeah, you have your drinking horn. And again, 20% alcohol, so it's a good mead. Yeah. Skål, Martin.
Skål.
And welcome to the Viking area.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and as you saw, I made a banner, a raven banner, that I can bring with me when I'm out on my little hikes here. And I actually made it myself. I hand painted it and put it on some leather. And that's why I have my spear with me today, because I made a fitting that I can put on my spear so that I can have the banner on. I hope you think it's cool. Yeah. And besides drinking mead and I think Martin has a beer. Then we are going to make a little lunch here, and I'm going to make some Viking flatbreads, and I also have bought some bacon. So we're going to make a bacon sandwich.
Nice.
I hope that will be nice too. Yeah. And the weather is perfect today. It's sunny, you can see, but not as warm. I think it's about 4 degrees Celsius,
yeah,
about that. So, well, I'm glad you joined us, and I hope you enjoyed our little trip here out in the wilderness. Skål again.
Yeah, skål. Skål. Mm. This is good meat.
Mm? Yeah, and Martin is trying to find some firewoods, and I'll put up my little fire system here. I think I was going. See if I can get this lower. Yeah. Yeah, and I'll start preparing the breads. Make my Viking flatbreads. Now I'm going to make 4, so I need a lot of flour. And again, some salt. Yeah. And last but not least, I need some honey for the breads. Like this. Yeah. And then some water. Yeah, just continue with this until it's, I can make some flatbread. Yeah, and now it's almost finished, and I'll let it rest for a while. Just putting something over it, so it will keep warm here. And Martin, let us see your new axe you made yourself. Yeah.
Yeah.
A little bit higher. Yeah.
So I made this axe from an old Danish axe head.
Mm-hmm.
And I've cut it out with a angle grinder.
So, yeah. You're good at this, Martin. I really envy you your skills there.
I'm pretty pleased yeah. with it.
It's really cool. And the handle, you have just bought a plain handle for axes and
yeah.
customized it.
Yeah, so it's a hickory handle.
Yeah.
And then I've just sanded it down so yeah. it fits my hand and,
yeah.
and then it's
You should make small. A tutorial about how you're doing that sometime.
Yeah, maybe Martin. I should, yeah. yeah.
It's really nice. I like it a lot.
Yeah, it's actually become a quite good
yeah.
Good axe.
Yeah.
So.
Then I'm going to I found some small twigs.
Yeah.
I'm going to make to start the fire with. I took this twigs of a spruce tree and I'm going to divide it in two ways. The small one here. And a little bit larger. First you have to start with the very fine twigs. And after that you can go ahead with the one that are just about a pencil or so in thickness, like these. But these small twigs are very important when you're starting a fire because a fire has to have something very dry and very small. And this will do nicely.
Yeah. And one of my subscribers, a man called Steven Nelson from the USA, has sent me a package with some stuff. And he actually made three kits for one kit for myself, one kit for my wife, and actually one kit for Martin. And because he's following Martin on his channel too,
right.
It's cool. So this is your Martin. And I'll bring the camera a bit closer so the viewers can see what it is that Stephen has made for you, because it's something that he has made for you, for us,
yeah.
Especially. And I think it's very awesome.
Nice.
So hang on.
Yeah. Yeah, and Stephen has sent me a lot of things. Among that, I think it was my easing picker, my Viking. But these Altoid tins that many of you are talking about in the USA, it's not something we can buy here in Denmark. So it's actually my first Altoid tin, and I think it's Martin's too. And
yes,
what is that,
yeah.
Martin, you're holding in your hands?
I'm pretty sure it's steel for fire making, for flint
yeah.
and steel, right?
I think it's made out of a file.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, and it's made three of these.
Oh,
remember that.
Really nice.
Really cool. And of course it's very durable for
fire striking.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And in the Altoid's tin, I can see there's some fatwood.
Yeah, there's some fatwood
yeah.
too. Nice.
And it smells very
oh,
nice.
Oh, it's really
yeah.
good fatwood.
Good fatwood.
Good fatwood.
No doubt about that.
No. Oh, nice.
Yeah.
There's some flint and some char cloth.
Mm-hmm.
And some yeah, I can't remember this fabric.
Cotton.
It's
yeah,
cotton, yeah,
denim. It's you can make more char cloth.
Yeah.
Out of this.
Oh, and there's a little.
Okay.
A little stamper for my pipe.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's cool.
And some I think it's dewdrine.
Yeah.
Dewdrine.
Yeah.
For fire making.
For fire making.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
So, let's try it out, right?
Let's do that, and
yeah.
there's some char cloth and down
nice.
You can use.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's use this for our fire making today.
Yeah.
Yeah. I come a little birch bark on here. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm gonna take some of this fat wood.
Yeah.
Make some shavings. For the fire.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Okay.
A You want to put the shavings inside your little bird nest?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I've taken some horse hair.
Yeah. So this is actually horse hair?
Yeah.
Well, have you tried that, anyone? I never tried that.
We're gonna try it today.
Yeah, it's cool.
So I'm putting the
fatwood shaving inside the bird's nest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's a small bird's nest, but
I think it's work.
I think it would do, yeah.
Yeah.
So let's try the flint and steel from Stephen.
Mm-hmm. There we are. Yeah.
So I like to take an extra piece of charcoal for it.
Yeah.
Just to be safe.
And when it's beginning to make a lot of smoke, it's actually when it's, yeah, you can see it lights up. Oh, that's nice, Martin. Yeah. I think it's going.
Yeah, the moment of truth.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a piece of fat in there. Yeah, we don't need that.
No, there's a lot of fire here. Martin, you're very pleased with this fire striker there.
Yeah.
I never seen this such one before, so it's cool, really cool.
It's really nice. I think I'll put a piece of leather in it and then have it around my neck when I'm out.
Yeah, that's really old school.
Yeah. Thank you, Stephen.
Yeah, thank you very much. And my wife say thank you also, because, well, she's not a bushcrafter, but she thinks it's a cool little set. Careful, enten din hammer eller din økse.
Din hammer.
Er de ordentligt gjort det her?
Nu skal jeg i hvert fald lave den op, når man kalder det en hammer.
You're laughing because I'm calling this a hammer.
Ja.
Ja. Now we're going to make some flatbreads.
I haven't tasted those Viking bread before, so I'm pretty excited about it.
Yeah, they're very neutral in the taste, but I think they are good. There's a bit honey in though, so they are a little bit sweet.
Okay.
I like that.
Yeah.
And it's actually a recipe that I've found on the internet that should be the one of the original recipes for flatbread. So, yeah, and very easy to make.
Yeah.
Nice. And but I'm going to make four, so yeah. Gonna take a little while. Let's see. The next one. Yeah.
Can I use your hammer again?
Yeah.
I have to give it lower here. Thank you.
And it's flatbread because it's very flat. Yeah. So I'm making this one. It seems to work fine. So now this is the last flatbread. So I'm going to clean this little skillet pan, and yeah, this is enough. I put a little oil on. Now we're going to make our bacon. And I bought some bacon that I have cut in big slices. Let's see. Now the bacon is finished, and we're going to make a bacon sandwich with flatbread. And one more, and then a moment, this one.
Ooh.
Doesn't look nice. Yeah, I think so. A bacon flatbread sandwich. Oops. Det sidste gik i stykker her. Ja, det går nok. Ja. Bon appetit.
Ja, yeah, thank you.
Mm. Mm.
Nice.
Thank you. And then it's time for coffee. Almost. Oh. Mm. A little extra bacon.
Oh. Thanks.
Mm.
This is really good.
Mm? Very delicious.
Yeah.
Mm?
Yeah, this mild bread is really good for the bacon.
Mm?
Mm?
It is tasty bread. Yeah, I like it.
Mm?
You had a beer more? We couldn't...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. Mm.
Skål, Martin.
Skål.
It's been a great day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It really has.
Now the most important, my coffee, our coffee. Yeah. And this bacon is for you and this is for me.
Okay.
Mm. Yeah, and instead of making coffee, I've decided we're going to make some chaga. Not chaga tea, but chaga coffee, as I call it. So I have two of these that I put in, and then it has to boil about half an hour. But Martin had never tasted that before, so I think this was a good opportunity to do that, to try it out. So, half an hour. Yeah, and while we're waiting for the chaga to boil, I would like to show you some other things I've got from a friendly subscriber. It's Troy from England. I think it's Birmingham he's living in. And he's actually sent me three things. This one. A brooch. A Viking brooch. I think it's so cool. Yeah. It looks so great. I can put it on my tunica. I love this very much, Troy. Thank you very much. And this one, also something I can perhaps use as a necklace or perhaps on my spear. I'm thinking about that. It's also Viking style. And beside that, I have got some earrings for my wife. And I put a picture up here somewhere so you can see that. It's very cool. So thank you very much, Troy. I really appreciate your generosity and your kindness. I worship these very much, and I will find a good place to put them on so that they will follow me on my upcoming adventures. Yeah, and I actually also got a new thing from Grimfrost. It is this, some dice. It's called Tafelkast, and it's mean a table throw. And it's very cool. It's made of a bone, I think, and like dice, it has numbers on here, 3 and 1 and 6 and so on. And I'm actually going to try to play this game with Martin, but I tried to find the rules for this game, and I couldn't find that. So if anyone out there know the rules about Tafelkast, please let me know. I would like to know a little bit more about this Viking, old Viking game that they made back in the times where the giant was here in Scandinavian. A cool little pouch for it too. So, yeah, Grimfrosts, if you are interested in some stuff from Grimfrost, go into their website, and in my video description I have a link, and if you use that, you actually support my channel, because I got a little out of that. So go into my video description, find the link, and buy from Grimfrost there. Yeah, and some of you maybe have noticed that I got a new neck knife. I'll tell you about this a little bit later, but it's the Ötzi knife from Condor. I had one before, but I lost it in the woods and I couldn't find it. So I bought a new one, and it's a very old school looking knife. And if you don't know about the Ötzi man, I put his name up here, down here, one, someplace you can go in and find about him. He was a man, a dead man that was found in the Alps some years ago, and he had a lot of things on him that was very well preserved. So Condor had made a replica, kind of replica of his knife. I love it. And yeah, then I put this on, and this is actually what we call Moskor mask. And it's on a stone, a rune stone that was found in the near Aarhus, in the middle part of Jutland, and this was a kind of protection mask that was carved in that stone. It's called Mosgaard mask. I'll put a link so you can find out. I think it's very cool and it's very Danish. And I just put it on this little sheath so it looks a little bit more like a Viking.
I like it a lot. Du kan se. Altså i virkeligheden så var det jo, jeg mener det var sten der var på det, altså flintesten. Ja. Så lavede de det der.
Ja. It's boiling a little bit. It just has to simmer for about half an hour. I think about 10 minutes and it will be ready for Martin to taste Tjaka coffee for the first time.
Now it's time for Tjaka. You have a cup with you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I'll pour you. See, it's almost as black as coffee.
It looks nice.
Yeah. And do you know something, Martin? It's actually very good with whiskey in.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
But perhaps you should taste it first without.
Yeah, it tastes really good.
Yeah, but put a little of this, my magical juice in.
Yeah.
It works. Works nicely. Skål.
Skål.
Oops. That's okay. Mm.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, I can definitely recommend a Tjaka with whiskey in.
Yeah, it really is good.
It's a good combination. Mm. Well, this is all for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed this little video. I'm glad Martin could join me. Martin from Northern Woodsmen. Go in and check his channel out. He makes some great content there. Yeah, it's been a wonderful day. We had a little meal, flatbread bacon sandwich and some chaga coffee, and had a good time. So, and we're going to make more of these videos where Martin and I are going to be making our Viking trips. So I hope you will follow us there. So go in, check him out. Yeah. Hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.
Oops, must be glimpsed in there.